Hello students, welcome back to e-learning. In this video we are going to learn engineering mechanics and strength of material subject. So in lecture 1 today we are going to understand the introduction to engineering mechanics. Firstly, we must understand what is force. So the external load applied on any body is called a force. For example, a hammer hit on any object. The hammer indicates the external force. So that is going to develop, or that is going to give us a force definition. So external load. So external load applied on a body is called force. Then force is nothing but a vector quantity, and SI unit for force is Newton. So here, what is vector quantity here? Vector quantity means that needs, or the force which needs magnitude and direction to describe the quantity. So force is termed as vector quantity. So, and its unit is given in Newton. Characteristics of force. Firstly, we will try to understand magnitude. Means characteristics of force, actually what does it mean? How a force should be, how the character should be of a force. We need to understand its magnitude of the force magnitude. Then the magnitude is given of a force with an length of the vector represents the magnitude of forces. So length of vector represents the magnitude of forces. Here is nothing but one of the vector or a force line drawn. Then direction of the force can be represented by an arrowhead. So this force, which is having an arrow showing in right top corner direction, so it indicates, the arrow head indicates the direction of the force in which it is acting. So this force is given by letter F. Line of action, third characteristic. Line of action, it is the line along which the force acts. So here you may see the dotted line. The force is acting in this path. So the path is indicating the line of action of that particular force. So point of application, it is the point at which the force is applied. So this force F is applied, say consider here there is one object. So it is nothing but the point of application on that particular object. So at what point the force is acting, it is said to be point of application. So these are the four characteristics of forces. So force, now here the magnitude, some people get confused what is exactly magnitude. So here it is said to be length of the vector represents the magnitude of force. But magnitude can be referred as size of the force, or mass of the force, or it's nothing but the speed while we travel. Okay, so magnitude can be the size of the force here in these terms. Next, we will concentrate on system of forces. Two or more forces acting on a body. So now for example, two or more branches of same bank, or two or more branches of same brand, you can say brand of any company. So all those branches together form a system. Similarly, number of forces form a system. So two or more forces acting on a body is called as is termed as system of forces. Coplanar force system. This system of forces are divided into two: coplanar force system and non-coplanar force system. So first we will try to understand what is coplanar force system. So coplanar force system. See, you can observe they lie on the same plane. The forces lie on the same plane. Say, consider a page is an example. A paper. Paper can be termed as one plane because it is having only x and y coordinates. So, in that particular plane, the forces which are acting are called to be coplanar forces. There will be no third direction or third secondary plane acting there. So, first we will try to understand under coplanar forces, the first one, coplanar collinear. So, here you can see the forces lie on the same plane. Here observe, there is x direction and y direction. It means this is one plane, vertical plane. Okay. There is no third direction z. It means there are no three dimensions or three planes acting or two planes acting. Only one single plane, vertical plane. In this vertical plane, there are three forces acting in a same line. F1 and F2 are acting in right direction and F3 is coming back towards the F1 and F2 in the same line. So, it is said to be same line of action. Okay. So, coplanar collinear forces lie on the same plane and are in same line of action. Okay. Next, we will concentrate on coplanar concurrent forces. Now, concurrent means emerging point or a single meeting point is called to be concurrent. So, coplanar means single plane again. Here also you can observe x and y. Only vertical plane is observed. In this vertical plane, a square plane, okay, there are four forces acting in different direction. Okay, F1 is coming outside from single point, F2 is coming from this emerging point, F3 is coming and meeting to that emerging point. So F4 is again exerting out from the same point. Okay, so it is how it can be defined. If the force lie in the same plane, okay, x and y means a vertical plane, and meet at the same point. See here, all the forces are emerging out, and this F3 is only one single force which is coming and meeting at the same point. So, meet at the same point, but they act in different directions. So, directions are different. F1 is coming down, F2 is coming on the right bottom, F4 is moving in upward direction. So, the directions may be different in this. So, third one we will concentrate now. It is nothing but coplanar, non-concurrent, non-parallel forces. So, first observe, non-concurrent, they have said. It means all these forces which are in same plane, same vertical plane, are not emerging out or meeting at a same point, non-concurrent. Okay. So, you may observe the line of action of F1 force is emerging from this point. F2 is also same, but F3 is emerging from different point. F4 is emerging from different point. So, it is said to be non-concurrent. Okay. And non-parallel. So, none of these forces are parallel to each other. So, they are non-parallel forces. So, coplanar, non-concurrent, non-parallel forces it is said to be. So, the line of action are in the same plane. Okay. Same vertical plane here. It may be horizontal plane also, it may be inclined plane, but it should be, the forces should be in single plane only, same plane. But they are neither parallel, the forces are not parallel to each other, and nor they meet the same point. So, hence they are called as coplanar, non-concurrent, non-parallel forces. Next, we will concentrate on coplanar parallel forces. See now, here you will get an idea of non-parallel and parallel forces. What is the difference? So coplanar, parallel forces. So line of action are in the same plane, but they are parallel to each other. Hence they are called as coplanar parallel forces. See here, F1 and F3 are acting in right direction, F2 is acting in left direction, but these all three forces are acting in parallelly. They are parallel to each other, and you can observe only there are X and Y. It means there is a vertical single plane, same plane. So these forces are acting in the same plane. For this coplanar parallel forces, there is an example related to civil engineering. So you can observe these two are nothing but the columns, okay, and W1, W2, W3 are nothing but the loads coming over the beam, okay, coming over the beam. So RA is nothing but the reaction at column A, RB is nothing but reaction at column B. So these two reactions are also called as forces acting in upward direction, and these three loads are acting in downward direction. But reactions are parallel to what? The loads. So that is why it is said to be coplanar parallel forces. Okay. So why coplanar? Because column and beam are in same vertical plane. Loads are acting in same plane. Reactions are also are in the same vertical plane. That is why this example can be very much related. So coplanar parallel forces. Okay. So nextly we will system of force, that is nothing but non-coplanar forces. So here the forces, first we will understand the planes here. Now see here, in this coplanar forces there was only one single plane, right? One vertical plane or one horizontal plane or inclined plane, any. But here you may observe there is horizontal plane here at the bottom, okay, X, Z, like this one rectangle, and X and Y one rectangle, vertical plane. So this bottom rectangle can be called as horizontal plane. Here it may be vertical plane on the right side, and Y, Z, here also there is one vertical plane on the left. So there are three planes here, but the forces, you may observe, the forces are in different planes which they are acting. They are acting in any direction, okay. Here this example is named non-coplanar concurrent forces. Concurrent in the sense they are meeting each other, but F1, F2, F3, F4 are coming from any direction of any plane. It may be from a horizontal plane, it may be from vertical plane, any direction, any plane. Okay, so if two or more forces are acting in different planes are said to be non-coplanar forces. Okay, so non-coplanar, the forces which are not acting in single plane, they may be from different planes. Okay, so it is said to be non-coplanar forces. So thank you guys, we will continue in lecture 2.